got in the amen. Oh no, blood all over the floor. Well, it's gone. I don't never change. No, always will be gone.
Sorry, I didn't let you finish your solo, Blind Willie Johnson. Today I think I'm going to focus on, a little bit just being grateful, because ever since I started doing this in the morning, doing my devotion and then doing, like talking through, this stuff, which I guess I sort of consider a form of worship, ever since I started doing this, and just doing this first and foremost, this is like the first thing I do in my day, I have been filled with such a creative fever. It's been awesome. It's been a sort of a high, and I think part of that, I guess, is the fact that I'm finally taking care of first the thing that matters most to me, the thing I believe is my, like, you know, numero uno purpose above all else, and it was hard for me to come to that point, honestly. And I was saying this last night to Karen Foreman, as we were kind of talking through a lot of stuff I've been talking about over the past couple of weeks, actually, funnily enough, and then I was like, oh my gosh, well, I had this thought, and I'm wondering why I've just been so focused on the old suffering thing, and the death of the old, and the birth of the new, and all that stuff, and then it just keeps cycling back into my zone, and last night, I think I was actually hopefully able to be helpful, just because I've been thinking about it so much, and then I was like, oh yeah, well, and I felt like this might be true too, and this was true, and then, and this has really helped me, and then, that was awesome, but, so it's not only given me a blessing in that arena, but it's given me a blessing in this creative way as well, because I'm just getting first things first, and keeping my eye first thing on the most important thing, and, oh, the thing I was saying, it took me a while to give up, and I don't even know when it happened, but sometime recently, where I was like, throughout my life, I've sort of struggled with what my number one purpose is, and right now, and I'm loving it, that my number one purpose is as a child of God, and my number two purpose, formerly, or quite often, the one that slipped into the number one, is an artist. I could say actor, I guess, writer, but I'm just gonna be pretentious and say artist, and for whatever reason, that's in number two now, and I'm getting more art, my artistic side is being better fed when I'm chasing my number one goal than when I just chase that as my number one goal. I guess because that'll never truly fulfill me in the ways that I need fulfilling in that eternal sense, you know what I mean? It'll fill little bits and pieces of that eternal thing, I'd believe that, and then, but it'll never... it'll never completely consume that area that I need to be consumed, you know? So that's been a super-duper blessing. So I just want to focus on that today and be super-duper grateful. And then my other thing, my devotion was about prayer today. And I kind of realized, sort of asked in it, like, sort of why you pray. And they were like, oh, well, you know, and you pray because Jesus prayed. And I was like, huh. And I was like, I actually... sort of prayed that this morning. I was like, Lord, why do we pray? Like, I know prayer is kind of about communion and about kind of coming before the altar and laying my burdens down and then making sure I do not, after laying them down and finish praying, I do not pick my burdens back up and walk out with them in a fit of martyr pique. I do that. But I guess, as I'm trying to just walk closer and closer with him, that prayer for me right now anyway is just about, is about sharing. And I believe in this, if this God created the whole universe, then he's obviously omnipotent, or pretty dang powerful, and listening, knowing what I got going on should be of no surprise. But I guess it's not even about that, oh, I'm going to surprise him. but that just I'm sharing it all, just as I would with a best friend or Archie, or, you know, just here's what's all going on with me. I don't want anything hidden from you. I know nothing's hidden, but I want to say it to you myself. I want to tell you the story, and I need help. I need your help with all of this, and your will be done. And then part of it too, which I don't know if I ever really explored until someone sort of, Jill Lamatina, I think it was the first time I ever like sat and actually meditated and needed a guided meditation, and I was like, oh wow, there's something here that is something there's something here that I should have been doing my entire life when I go and pray to God. And that's just that emptying, like I was talking about before, emptying of self and filling with him, and just being there, just hanging out at the feet of your master. So that's what I'm going to try to do today, just hang out at the feet of my master, and try not to, when I'm asking, don't be ashamed to ask, don't be ashamed to praise, and just walk in that light and the truth all day long. Help me, Lord.